Hello everyone, welcome back to part 10 of this Let's Play series, Life is Strange Before the Storm. So we had a run-in at the Amber's house with Elliot. He kind of turned from Simp 1000 over to Danger 1000. And we managed to get the money. We know that Rachel's dad is working with Damon at least to remove Sarah from Rachel's life. Sarah right now is at the mill. That's where we're headed to. We got the money for Damon. He thinks that we're Rachel's dad, James, however. And hopefully we can save Rachel's mom and get them reunited. So with that, let's play part 10. Taking the guitar riff on this one.
Destruction. All because Rachel got angry at her dad, who's been lying to her all her life, and he's still lying.
Drama!
Hey, being a dad's tough.
That doesn't justify what he's done.
I'm just saying, I'd probably do anything to keep you safe.
Hey, Dad?
Yeah?
Did you ever lie to me? I don't mean telling me that ashtray I made for Mom wasn't a piece of crap. I mean, like, really lied about something that might hurt me to know.
What do you think?
I think the dad was an honest guy. You know, besides, you know, lying about maybe Santa Claus when they were kids or, you know, I think he was as honest as he can be.
I think you didn't. You didn't have to. You didn't. Right?
Would you love me less?
Of course not.
You sound pretty sure, sweetheart. You were pretty sure Mom would never fall in love with someone like David, too. Are you really ready to hear the answer to your question?
Ready as I'll ever be.
Problem is, I'm dead. So how am I supposed to tell you anything?
I can't tell you anything. I'm dead. Figment of your imagination. Peace. It's probably better this way. I think she knows
the
answer.
Yeah. Not knowing.
Everyone kind of knows.
I'll always be the perfect dad.
Not many people get to say that.
I mean, it's the idea that if you're gonna criticize your parents and become a parent yourself, I mean, you gotta hold yourself to the same standard, right?
No word. My ride, my tunes. seriously going in to face Demon Merrick? All for Rachel? Am I crazy?
Hella crazy.
I'm glad you're here, Dad.
You don't want me to go?
No. I like the company. Besides, you don't want to miss this. Things are about to get real.
Yeah, let's go. I like the vignettes with the dad. Kind of gives her, you know, a sense of closure. And as you play her, you know, you feel, you get that closure too.
Is that blood?
Oh, God. Is that from the knife scuffle that they had in the scrapyard?
Frank?
Pompadour.
Frank! This is bad. I'll get you help, Frank. But first, I've got to help Rachel's mom.
It's dying in his RV right now. Oh, this place burned up pretty nice, too. Wow. Hope you got insurance.
Where the hell is Sarah?
Tag it though.
Don't tell me what to do.
I'll get the option. Maybe I can get that knife.
A knife might not be a bad idea. Never thought I'd have to say that.
Hopefully you don't need to use it.
No more beer. No more time. I've got to keep moving. Where's the homicidal drug dealer, Spooky Deerhead?
Is there anything on this side?
Frank's couch is toast.
Yeah, I didn't want to touch the phone because that's probably going to be like, come upstairs. The instruction phone. So that's
no.
Gerald's phone.
Shh.
Everything's going to be just fine. Just a little longer, and all your troubles are going bye-bye.
What the fuck?
He's trying to drug her.
I just want to meet my daughter. Can't you understand why does
your daughter? Jesus.
Bloody nose.
So that's what he's worried about. Can't let the public know. The mother of his daughter is some junkie.
I just want to see her. You don't have to.
Shut up. James Amber wants you out of the picture. So that's what's going to happen.
This is so messed up.
ship. She's probably, you know, haven't used after for all, a long time.
No one believes a junkie.
No.
He said you've been sober a year.
There you go.
Respect. It's hard to kick this shit.
You can do this. Damon.
What the hell are you doing here?
I've got your money right here. The money James owes you.
How the fuck do you...
Run!
No one has to know. Just let her go, and I won't say...
Ah, jeez. Should've used the knife.
Talking's over.
Leave her alone!
Shut up. What the fuck? You boosted the DA's shit? Got my money? Burned the evidence? All that?
I'm just... trying to help.
Get away from her!
I said shut the fuck up!
No.
No.
Go to your fucking happy place.
Run.
Let this be a lesson, kid. Make good life choices, or you'll end up like her. Now, what do I do with...
Damon! What did you do?
I fucked you up good, didn't I? Guess you really don't know when to quit. Glad to see you back on your feet.
Chloe.
Frank.
You don't really want to do this again, do you? Okay. Then I don't want to do this again. Come on, man. Fuck you.
Oh. The head punt.
Rachel. Your daughter. She...
Hopefully Frank won.
I saw you in the play. You were funny.
Thanks.
Sit.
It's a dream.
Sarah, are you okay?
We need to talk about what happened.
I am so, so sorry for
Rachel. Can never know.
What exactly can't Rachel know?
What James did. Hiring that thug. Shooting me up with...
He's a piece of shit. And I promise that...
Rachel... can never know.
I don't know why.
Tell me why. Doesn't she deserve to know what her father did?
No. Rachel deserves a loving father. A father who cares for her.
James is a liar!
James is a desperate man who loves his daughter. And she loves him. Tell her what happened here, and you'll take that away from her. Forever.
She deserves to be happy, but that's the thing about these types of situations. Like, I mean, is that a genuine happiness if she doesn't know the full truth or how it came about, or ignorance is bliss? I think she deserves to meet her. Especially, you know, she's overcome a lot of struggles and stuff like that. It seems like she got her life back together. She's been sober for a year. You know, she's doing it all just to meet her daughter, so.
And just, what is James protecting her from? You? She wants to meet you, Sarah.
No, she doesn't. She wants to meet her mother. I can never be that for her.
Why are you saying all this?
Because James is right. He's taken something from me that I might not ever get back. But he's right. I'm broken.
Everybody's broken.
No, you're not. You're stronger than you realize.
You don't know anything about me.
I know Rachel needs you. I know loss. I lost my father 2 years ago.
How?
Car accident. He was picking up my mother from the grocery store, and a truck ran a red light, and that was it.
I'm sorry. You don't know what this is to me. Every pain. Every fear. Gone. No more sadness. No more grief. Why would anyone not want to feel that way? Ever.
I heard what Damon said. You've been sober for a year. You beat this before. You can beat it again.
No. I can't.
I recognize I might not know what the fuck I'm talking about here, but I wish you could know how amazing Rachel is.
I know.
She's fearless. She's brilliant. And talented. And she feels so much. She's so strong.
She's had a good life. Raised in a loving home. Given opportunities I could never give her.
At least talk to her. She's felt like something's been missing her whole life. She told me so. That something was you.
She didn't miss anything. She has a perfect family.
Even without all this shit, the Ambers are far from perfect. James is an elitist asshole, and Rose lets him walk all over her.
Maybe. What Rachel needs, though, is not to have her father taken away from her.
He doesn't deserve...
It's not about James. It's not about me, and it's not about you. It's about Rachel.
Yeah, it should be Rachel's decision.
Tell her what James did, and you'll be killing him for her. You understand that, don't you? You lost your father. Do you really want to put Rachel through that?
I can't lie to Rachel. I won't do it. She trusts me. And I don't want to ruin that.
If you love her, you'll lie to her. Nothing can change the mistakes I made. I'll never get to be Rachel's mother. Not really. But there's one thing I can still do for her. The only thing I can do. Let me give her the father she deserves. The one who raised her. Protected her. The one who loves her more than anything. You can do whatever you want, Chloe. You have the power. What you have to decide is whether you're going to protect Rachel or cause her even more hurt.
I said this before in one of my secret public diaries, so but good friends tell you things are going to be okay, but great friends, best friends tell you things are not going to be okay.
She can without me.
You're just kind of trading one lie for the other.
Wait.
Is what my opinion is.
Don't go, Sarah. I'm done here. Goodbye, Chloe.
Hopefully this was a dream sequence. Wow, I guess not.
Hello?
Hi, Chloe. Rachel's just fallen asleep.
I know she'll be thrilled to see you when she wakes up. Maybe come back a little later?
Hey.
Go back to sleep, kiddo. You need your rest.
Can I talk to Chloe? Alone? For a minute?
Okay, sweetie. We'll be right outside.
How are you feeling? Like I got stabbed? Doc says there'll be a sick scar. Maybe a tattoo is in order. Fuck yeah. We never actually escaped, did we? We've got time.
Wait, what the fuck?
All the time in the world. So, how did everything go? Rachel, I've got to tell you something.
No more lies, man. Gotta have this difficult conversation. We'll be right back. yes, Frank did win. In handcuffs. Yeah, the servers are down. Sorry about that, guys. This is a great game. Nice. Oh no. I guess we know what happens. I got my 12 game series for the first Life is Strange. So if you want to know what that means, and let's play the bonus episode. We got some time. But yeah, that was a fantastic game. Really well done. Yeah, definitely gave a lot more context to the first game. I might play the first Life is Strange game again, just knowing what I know.
Ready? I guess. But isn't your mom gonna freak? She's probably cooking with the radio on. She won't hear a thing. I bet she'll notice a hole in the floor. Trust in science, Max. Even when science means blowing shit up.
Nice.
Tell me that wasn't the coolest thing you've ever seen!
That was truly amazing. Why are explosions so awesome?
That's like asking, why are puppies cute? Some things just are.
I'm not sure your mom would see it that way.
When she asked me to get rid of my old junk, she never specified how. But I guess I better do some actual cleaning, too. I'll be excavating the closet. If you see anything else to trash, help a girl out and chuck it on the pile over there.
It feels like I've spent half my life hanging out in this room. Probably because I have. I can't believe those days are all over now.
Young Max.
In a few days, my whole family moves to Seattle. I have no idea when I'll see Chloe again. This could be my last chance to say goodbye. Help Chloe with her cleaning. And while I'm at it, I can take one long last look around this place. Chloe's mom wanted us to go through this pile of old clothes and find stuff to donate. Instead, we played dress up for an hour.
That's what you're supposed to do, right?
Chloe's had this hung up on her wall forever, but neither of us can figure out what happened to the last panel. I hope Dr. Klohenstein's okay. Chloe's always preferred imaginary animals to real ones. Well, besides Bongo, of course. Oh, this was our first unsupervised concert together. It was so much fun. We were supposed to see another show next month, but...
How sick was that show?
The sickest.
I've been working on my moves for the next one. Check it out. How about you? Any new moves?
Yeah, totally. I've been working on my air guitar.
Just, a couple
of white ladies just dancing.
All right, back to the junk mines.
At least we got to go to one concert together before I left. Chloe and I haven't played this game in forever. And I'm pretty sure it's missing pieces.
You mean you had an oopsie with the oopsie game? That's the thing with board games. If you're missing a piece, you know.
What are you doing?
Adding this to the pile.
No freaking way. Just because I beat your ass every time we play doesn't make it trash.
That's BS. The last time we played, I wiped the floor with you.
Poor Max. Losing your memory at such a young age. Guess we'll have to play again soon and find out.
I can see why Chloe has such a hard time cleaning out her room. Let this box of trash be a sacrifice to you, O almighty Chloe Bear. As usual, Chloe's grades are better than mine. I still think her butt in PE, though. That was awesome. Who else but Chloe could turn cleaning her room into a pyrotechnical adventure? I think Chloe used to call this guy Mr. Sharky. I doubt she plays with it anymore.
Just kind of want to see, I don't want to trash it, but I want to see the reaction when I'm attempting to.
You better not be thinking what I think you are.
Chloe, I haven't seen you touch this guy in years. Why do you care?
Why do I care? If you throw my beloved childhood friend into the trash? I don't think that deserves an answer.
Sorry, chum.
That's better.
Chloe's been beating me for a while, but that growth spurt could come any day now.
I think Chloe ends up being taller than Max. In the end.
We bought this as a gag years ago. I honestly can't believe Chloe still has it.
What kind of gag that is?
What about this half-eaten jawbreaker? A serious biohazard.
You promised me we'd finish it together no matter how long it took. Don't be a quitter.
You're right.
Yes! The never-ending candy lives on.
They're swapping spit.
Okay, whenever I'm ready, I can go tell Chloe I'm done arguing about trash with her. Chloe's had this hoodie for years. It's her favorite. I don't think she'd mean to throw it away.
I'm gonna see if there's anything on this side of the room that I missed here.
People say a lot of things about the Prescott family, but this is pretty cool.
It's a Blackwell acceptance letter.
I bet Chloe's parents were freaking out when she got this letter.
Marco Gonzalez. Not sure if we actually met that guy. Surprised that it's addressed to the parents and not the child who's actually attending.
I still can't believe you're a Blackwell Academy student. How is it?
Oh, the classes are incredible. The teachers are actually smart. And the lab is legit.
Yeah, especially this one photograph teacher.
What about the students? Are they as stuck up as you thought they'd be?
They're... fine.
Victoria's awesome.
Chloe, you're terrible at hiding your feelings.
Is everything okay?
I don't know. I like hanging out with normal people. Like you.
Thanks. I guess.
You know what I mean. I hate fake people. You're real.
Thanks. Hey, what's your dad's camera doing in here?
Dad said I could bring it up here for you to use. He's tired of watching you drool all over yourself every time he uses it. His words.
Your dad is the best.
Sure. Just don't ever tell him that. We need to keep him on his toes. You're off to a great start.
Actually, it's kind of cool. Chloe's such a nerd. She hangs on to all her old textbooks and school supplies.
I do that too.
Chloe keeps trying to get me to hop on her board. I'd rather take pictures. Whoa. Talk about embarrassing. How about these boy band trading cards? Super cringeworthy.
Yeah, and hilarious. Remember when we gave them all makeovers?
You mean when you drew boobs on all of them? I was so mad at you.
And yet, our friendship lived on. So too will these cards.
Look at everything here.
As usual, Chloe's grades are better than mine. I still kick her butt in PE, though.
Here's a hard conversation coming up.
That's it. I'm calling off the search. If you want more trash, you'll have to find it yourself.
Well, it wasn't exactly the purge Mom was hoping for, but at least we tried, right?
Right.
And now we've got the whole day ahead of us. What do two under-supervised friends with clean rooms and clean slates want to get into today?
I guess now would be a good time to tell Chloe I'm leaving. Or I could let us enjoy the day first and tell her later.
Gotta enjoy the day.
The possibilities are endless. Got anything in mind?
Actually, you bet your ass I do. I found this when I was digging around before you got here. You're gonna flip! Do you have any idea what this is?
Whatever it is, it looks like it came out of our pirate phase.
Your powers of deduction are as strong as ever. This tape is from 5 years ago. It's a message from our past selves to our current selves.
Oh, God.
So we were 8 years old? That's crazy. I can't even imagine what we sounded like.
Ready to find out?
Avast, future wayfarer! Ye have uncovered the audio log of the most fearsome pirates in the bays of Arcadia! Captain Bluebeard and Long Mask Silver!
You are such dorks.
So, you're in search of buried treasure, are ye? Well, if it's treasure ye seek,
mine eyes spot two fair pirate wenches.
Dad, get away! We're in the middle of an important project!
Oh, a project? Never mind then. I apologize.
I mean it!
All right. Supper's in five. Wash your hands, you grubby pirate kids.
So lame. As I was saying, if it's treasure ye seek, ye've come to the right place. Be forewarned, the journey will be treacherous and full of treachers.
Nice.
To find the treasure of Price Isle, you will need the map from the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard. Only the map can lead ye to the treasure ye seek. But be forewarned. Again, only those pure hearts will be able to see what the amulet shows them.
The amulet.
Good luck. And, bye.
Dude, that was...
That's kind of dorky.
So dorky. What were we thinking?
I thought we were lovable.
Okay, forget everything. Today, we go treasure hunting. I think I know what 8-year-old you meant by the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard.
Our old sketchbook. This is where we kept all our pirate drawings.
Yep. Now let's see this map.
It's actually like a pretty good drawing of pirate ship by Kid. It's better than I can do. The Bane of Arcadia. Pogo the Pirate.
This looks like a page was ripped out. I wonder if it's the map.
Looks like the outline of a box for a map.
Hey, check this out. This page was ripped out. Do you think it's the map?
If it is, there's no way I would have thrown it out. Maybe it's mixed in with the rest of the drawings?
All right. Time to find this map. Chloe and I were doing a lot of drawing in Miss Shelley's class. I wonder if the map is mixed in with her school supplies from that year. I think this was the first class Chloe and I had together. Not sure I learned much about the Stars and Stripes. Bingo.
Telescope and the amulet, which we hid inside a dark cavern, aka the attic.
Ugh, why did we do that to ourselves?
Because we were 8 years old and the attic was the scariest place we could think of.
You think it's still there?
Should be, as long as the clean police haven't gotten to it first.
Okay, and once we have the amulet and the telescope, we use them to reveal the treasure. Somehow.
Here's what's happening. I'll head to the garage to dig up my old telescope. You go find that amulet. We'll meet out back at the pirate ship.
You mean the swings?
Yes, the pirate ship. Captain Bluebeard and Long Mac Silver ride again, bitches!
Chloe seems so into this. If this has to be my last day here, might as well have one
final pirate adventure. Okay, Chloe said she hid the amulet in the attic. The only way... The entrance to the dark cavern is in there.
Yeah, I cut that off.
Bluebeard's chosen hiding place for the mysterious amulet.
See if there's anything else we can take a look at before
Seems
going
like
in
Chloe's
there.
Dad always has a project around the house. I guess Chloe never really grew out of wanting to be a pirate. Chloe's mom bought me a toothbrush because I spend the night here so often. Well, I used to. The things inside this cabinet haven't changed very much over the years. Makeup is great for acting in Halloween costumes. Any other time, I just don't get it. I can't believe I won't be able to call Arcadia Bay home much longer.
Oh, you'll be back.
I don't think I've ever actually seen anyone reading these books. It's awesome that Chloe's mom wants to teach kids. She'd be really good at it. Most strikes? How can that be so cool and so dorky at the same time?
That's an amazing trophy.
Chloe's mom is trying to quit smoking. Is that an email from the principal at Blackwell? Chloe did act a little strange when I asked her about school earlier. The principal at Blackwell wants to meet with Chloe's parents. I wonder what about. Did Chloe get into a fight? She never gets in trouble. I'm glad her dad stood up for her. A voicemail? I wonder if it's still there. Sometimes I really wish I had siblings. Chloe hasn't mentioned a trip. Maybe it's supposed to be a surprise. Oh, so cool. Chloe is such a nature nerd. I bet she's gonna love it. The two whales makes the best Belgian waffles. No other diner could even come close.
Like
it's
a...
so sweet that Chloe's mom takes this photo with her to work.
That's nice.
I don't think I could ever handle a real-life murder investigation.
Really?
I always like to imagine I could open that wardrobe and step into another world.
Narnia. We go down Luke's pocket.
I slipped and broke this post a few years ago. But Chloe insisted on taking all the blame. Even after she got grounded, she never squealed. What a friend.
Yeah, sticks up for her friends.
I've gotta find that amulet before I meet Chloe out back. There it is, the dark cavern. Crap. I can't get into the attic if I can't even reach the door. I need to find something to stand on. I'm sure I can find something around here to boost me up.
Is there anything here?
Maybe this will make me tall enough to reach.
It's a start. I gotta find something I can stack on top of it. I think that'll be a good base to stack things on.
Something in Chloe's room I could use?
Chloe's room has always been home base. It's hard to think this might be the last scheme we ever plan here.
A toolbox, I could stand on the toolbox.
Seems like Chloe's dad always has a project around the house. Just need a few more inches.
I know we're approaching an hour, but we'll continue to play this bonus episode until it's done, so don't you worry.
Not bad for an improvised stepladder, but it's still not tall enough.
Probably put the toolbox on there, right?
It seems like Chloe's dad always has a project around the house. I slipped and broke this post a few years ago. But Chloe insisted on taking
maybe it could have been removable.
Even after she got grounded, she never squealed. What a friend.
Hurried. Can we enter Chloe's room?
Chloe's room has always been home base. It's hard to think this might be the last scheme we ever plan here. Makeup is great for acting in Halloween costumes. Any other time? I just don't get it.
Is there anything else in here I could use?
I just need a few more inches.
We're in like sin. Oh, that's cool they have the pirate flag now.
There's a ton of stuff up here. How will I ever... There it is. Of course Chloe hid the amulet in the hardest place to get to. I need to find a way through. No Sharpie boob jobs. Disappointing. Her parents couldn't part with this. I guess I see where Chloe gets her sentimentality from.
It's cool they have a Chloe curved in there.
I can't get through with this chair here. I think I can squeeze through now. It's a good thing I'm big and burly. Otherwise, moving this furniture would be kind of difficult. I need to move that desk, but the dresser is in the way.
It's somewhat of a little slide puzzle that we got.
Keep it moving.
Crap.
One step closer. Chloe and I had the best Halloween costumes. Long Max Silver's eye patch.
Hell yeah.
This will be perfect. Hard to imagine Chloe's dad in college. I wonder what he was like. Maybe there's still some things in there.
Let's find out.
I guess Chloe's dad went through a hippie phase. Hard to imagine Chloe's dad in college. I wonder what he was like.
Okay.
That's so cool. I wonder how many different moments this thing has captured.
Is there anything on this side? No, I think that might be it.
Full of decorations Chloe made when she was 5. She thinks they're embarrassing, but I think they're cute. I remember this. Chloe refused to get another goldfish after she had to flush Calico Jack. Not a single country record. These must belong to Chloe's mom.
Okay, I guess we push that back, then pull out the cooler.
This desk's pretty heavy. Glad this thing is empty. Finally.
It's like a booby trap here or something.
A fitting reward for a journey full of treasures.
Let's take a photo.
This is a nice close-up shot. This thing is cool, I guess. I wish I could remember how it works.
Stay up there. I've got it! Nothing can stop the mighty Bluebeard.
Chloe Price, my best friend. It's so weird being back in this attic after so long.
I'm gonna hate breaking her heart, man.
I remember being terrified of this place. I think when you're a kid, you're only afraid of things that can hurt you. But when you get older, you become more afraid of hurting the people you care about. And spiders.
Ha ha! I have you now, Skellywag.
Does that look like a garden shovel?
I'm gonna miss her.
Oh man, it's time to break the news.
Are you just watching me up there, Creeper?
I like to watch. You gotta share, man.
You are one of a kind, Chloe Price.
What?
I'm lucky you're my best friend, that's all.
Damn right you are, you mushy weirdo. Did you find the amulet? Awesome. Now get your ass down here, we have treasure to find.
On my way.
Dark cavern was no match for you, eh? Long back Silver to the rescue.
Treasure's sure to be ours, Captain.
Bring the amulet over here so I can see.
Chloe is so excited. I better bring her the amulet before she makes me walk the plank. It's not that I don't like the blue. I'm just sad to see the old color go. One time, we stuck a bunch of this tape to Chloe's face to make a blue beard. Putting it on was a lot more fun than taking it off.
She doesn't have any chinny chin chin hairs.
This was a fun experiment. I'm almost surprised we actually managed to grow something. Poor Bongo. Chloe took his death so hard. I guess Chloe's mom comes all the way back here to smoke. Chloe and I have done lots of homework at this table. It's so weird we're at different schools now. I still wish I could live in the world we drew. I wish this was big enough to jump in.
It's only September. It'll be totally dive-bombable in a few weeks.
Yeah. A few weeks.
Yeah. Oh, this is gonna be so
really
awkward.
I'm really gonna miss Price family barbecues. Chloe's bottle rocket. The fastest way to get an entire bottle of soda in your hair.
Yo-ho, yo-ho, a pirate's rum for me. Did you drink this? Yar!
No, not really. I had to fish an empty bottle from the recycling bin.
That's probably for the best.
Some pirate you are.
Hey, Chloe.
Yar!
Land ho! Perfect.
Oh.
God, I hate bumblebees. Or wasps. Oh. Flying syringes of poison, men.
I wish I could freeze this moment. I never have to leave it.
You could probably go back in time, eventually. You know what I'm saying?
Glider swings. The best way to simulate a storm on the high seas.
Wait just a minute. Yarr! You must ask permission before setting foot, or peg, on another captain's boat.
Permission to come aboard, Captain Bluebeard?
Granted.
One amulet, coming right up. Okay, I think it goes... Damn it. I forget how to make this stay on.
Stay here. I think I saw some tape.
Thanks, Max. Just some tape left between us and the treasure. Score. One step closer to getting that treasure. Whatever it is.
Avast, matey. Have you brought me prize?
Ahoy, Bluebeard. I have brought the stickiest tape in all the
seven. The stickiest.
Well done, fellow scallywag.
Just like old times. Come, Max. Remember how we used to talk about ruling the bays of Arcadia one day? We thought we were gonna be pirates forever.
If being a pirate means acting silly and going on crazy adventures together, then we'll always be pirates.
Hell yeah.
Would you like to do the honors, Long Max Silver?
Me?
Are you sure?
Of course. Come on, Navigator. Point me to some treasure.
Well, let's check it out.
Wait. How am I supposed to use this?
The drawing on the lens. It should line up with... something?
Here goes nothing. Okay. This drawing is supposed to line up with something.
Oh, okay.
I think the drawing should turn the real world into something piratey.
It's gotta be on the ground somewhere.
Have the right angle, but where does it line up?
Oh, here we go.
Got it.
Yes! You rock! Where is it? Here?
Okay. Take a step right.
Wait, that's her right. Oops.
No. The other right.
My other right or your other right?
My other right.
Got it. Wait, what?
Just go that way. Perfect. Now come towards me.
And right there.
Bingo.
Bingo. was that?
What is this?
I don't know. Let's open it.
Aww.
From Bloody Bill. Who's that?
I'll get the tape player.
That's a cool dad.
Aha. Chloe's dad is such a goofball.
Ahoy there, plank walkers! It's me, Bloody Bill, the Pirate King.
What the heck?
By now, you'll have seen that I dug up your treasure, which would normally make us mortal enemies. But hear me out. I haven't pilfered a thing. On the contrary, I figured you swashbucklers might not be back to your loot for some time, so I've given it extra protection from the winds and rain. I'm sure you're excited to open your time capsule, so I won't go on too long. Just know that Bloody Bill is bloody proud of you.
Aww.
Keep those sails trimmed and that anchor scrubbed, and always remember, the real treasure is
friendship, love.
Your Oregon State prepaid college savings.
Nice. Always thinking ahead. Using those compound returns.
That's what we originally buried.
Huh, yeah. I guess it probably would have gotten ruined underground.
Holy crap! It's Billy the Squid! He's alive!
Oh, man!
It really is like a time capsule.
No way!
Chloe, look at this. We wrote each other letters.
Oh, I remember these. To Chloe Price. Thanks, Max. I hope you are having a lot of fun being a teenager with your best friend.
Oh boy.
You were so cute. Check it out.
Ugh, Maxine.
Right. So she does like science, yeah. Wow.
How about mine? What did I write?
This is so Chloe.
To use on the gold band, all right.
You were really sweet.
Oh man, I was really goopy.
I like it.
That's because you're a goop.
This is so cool. There's so much to look at.
Is your mom going to mind about this mess?
Dunno. I thought they'd be home by now.
Max, remember scratch art? Oh, I love this stuff.
I'm gonna draw something.
Oh, man.
All these memories. I want to look at everything. This container looks like it could last 100 years.
Holy crap. It's the end of that comic in Chloe's room. Oh, this is gross.
These are awesome. Chloe's always been good at making up cool things to do. a time capsule was such a good idea.
I know, right? We're geniuses.
Most of these are pretty far off base. It's so hard to predict the future.
Medium
Maybe
popular.
It's better to enjoy the present instead. It actually might be really fun to write letters to Chloe after I move. Is writing once a week too often? Will I run out of things to say? Recording things was so much fun in third grade. It's good to see you, old friend.
Sorry, really?
Keep messing up my picture.
There are no mistakes in art. We always make so much more of a mess here than at my house.
Just happy accidents, according to Bob Ross.
Manga might be the one thing where Chloe out-nerds me. This is probably the last thing Chloe's mom wants to see after a shift at the diner.
Max. Always thinking about other people.
Much better.
Somebody's a goody two-shoes.
I always look especially short next to Chloe.
Oh yeah, Chloe is taller. But hey, this is the photograph.
That was a good week. I used every possible excuse to be here for breakfast.
If you want to know what that photograph means, you should watch my other game series, Life is Strange.
I bet there's some really cute photos in there. I wonder if I could recreate this photo with Chloe now. Looks like Chloe's a lot more responsible than I am with my allowance. Chloe and I have been friends for so long. Maybe I'm worrying too much about this move changing things. I still haven't told Chloe about my news. I can do that after I finish looking at everything. Hey, what if my being in Seattle finally convinces Chloe to try an MMO? I could use this to recreate that old photo of Chloe.
Yes.
Pose for a photo with that. Okay, tip your head back and put your arms out. And a really big smile.
Like this?
It's perfect. Stop moving. Really cute, Chloe.
You're not so bad yourself.
Chloe and I spilled that wine months ago, but I still feel bad about it. That's so cool that Chloe's mom is thinking about this. You sure were troublesome to find. Thank you. Now you've got something pretty to look at. Recording things was so much fun in third grade.
Oh boy.
This used to be the rainy day pirate ship. You're such a space hog. Move over.
Nope.
Oh, man. So this is, we'll see each other again, I guess. It's time to give the news. It's time.
Chloe looks so content when she's drawing. Is that what I look like when I'm taking pictures?
Hey, hippie.
How's the masterpiece?
Working on the last bit. How about you? Done with the time capsule?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, perfect, because now I'm finished. Check it out.
This is so silly.
Oh, boy.
This jawbreaker is going to last forever?
Just like our friendship.
Oh, Chloe, you were really drawing me that whole time.
Whoa. Mushiness alert. Keep it together, Max.
I guess now's my chance to tell Chloe I'm leaving. We might not be alone again once her parents get back.
Hey, ready for something else? I've got a great plan for the afternoon.
Crap. I don't want to ruin the rest of the day.
You're staying for dinner, right?
Would Chloe even
yeah,
want
just
me not to
breakfast
tell her?
Tomorrow.
She didn't like me getting mushy just now.
Oh, shit.
Max?
It's just Seattle. I'm probably overstressing about the whole thing. Right?
We gotta tell her, man.
Chloe?
Max?
I want to tell you something.
Okay.
My family's moving to Seattle really soon. Hey.
In 3 days, right?
What? You knew that?
Our parents do talk, you know?
But they said I should be the one to tell you.
They still told my parents. I guess Mom and Dad were trying to keep quiet too, but they're bad at hiding anything.
It's kind of cool Chloe was cool about the entire thing and...
Don't look so worried, Max. It's okay. Come on, Dorkmeister. It's not the end of the world.
I should have just told you earlier. God, I feel so stupid.
Max, I said it was okay.
I thought about telling you this morning, but then I just felt guilty instead.
Well, I'm glad you didn't. Then it would have been hanging over us all day. That's why I didn't bring it up either. Plus, I know you hate this kind of conversation, so I just left it alone, you know? Come on. I want to spend every minute we have together having fun.
We'll keep in touch, okay? And visit and
Maybe we'll move back. Who knows?
Chill out. We can go to college together. It's gonna be fine. We're Max and Chloe, remember? We're always together. Even when we're not.
That's true.
Cool. Let's find something fun to do.
Okay, so I guess this takes place after father left to okay.
Black flies on the windowsill. We are that we are that we are to know. Winter stole summer's thrill, and the river's cracked and cold. See, the sky is no man's land. A dark and plumed estate. Hope it needs a humble hand. Not a fox found in your place.
Thinking if I could just see you, but we'll get good at it, great at it. We'll write and talk all the time, and then you'll come visit, and It'll be like I never left. I mean it. You don't have to worry about anything changing. You're dealing with so much other stuff. You don't deserve any of this. Chloe, listen. Even if we're moving for good, we are always together, okay? Even when we're apart, we're still Max and Chloe. I will always, always love you.
Well, that was a great bonus episode by Don't Nod Entertainment. Great game, fantastic game. I'm glad we got to meet Rachel. If I could do it all over again, I'd probably play Before the Storm, play through the bonus episode, then Life is Strange. Man, this is as close to a perfect 10 as you can get. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Hit the notification bell. I'm going to get a new microphone. Right now I'm using a Snowball microphone, which is great, but connections were a little bit loose, and I had to re-record some areas because I wasn't getting any sound from my microphone. So I'm going with a new mic sometime next week, and that's when I'll tackle Life is Strange 2, which... I think takes place in Arcadia Bay 2 as well, but it's a completely different story separate from this. But this was a wonderful job. I'm glad that they're making more games. If you check out the channel, I played through Life is Strange, the first one, as well as their newest one, Tell Me Why. And Life is Strange 2, I'll be playing through sometime next week. So again, stick with us, and yeah. Great, great job. Great storytelling. I enjoy these types of games, so. Very well done. Bravo. Again, like, comment, subscribe. This is 1-800-LAWYER-UP from FormalFocus.com. Hopefully you enjoyed this series. I enjoyed playing it, and I will see you next time.